Buongiorno, this was my view every morning from the restroom while I brushed my teeth, and the window I like to have breakfast from every morning as well.
There's a world outside my door. I don't know it anymore. I'm gonna stay here now.
Shortly after arriving, they gave us our placements and when we would be starting and what time.
Much of darkness in my mind. It's gonna take me down. It's gonna take me down all the roads I've been before. Same mistakes always got me shaken. And all the signs I once ignored in my denial. I didn't want to face them.
I was so surprised to see the very narrow streets in which even two cars at a time would fit, going different directions, and there was so many people walking by, having to move over, otherwise they would just honk at you, and so many scooters, and it was just a very different experience to what I'm used to here in San Diego. I was so shocked to see all of the graffiti and the trash all over Napoli, and although it's such a beautiful city, it really needs to be cleaned out, and it just shows how important that is for our environment. I was so in love with seeing all of the music and all of the art all over the city and how much pride these people take in living here and growing up here. And all they want to do is share that with you and tell you all there is to see in Napoli. Big, beautiful, amazing views like this just make you realize how small of a person you really are, but also how much of a difference you can make. Even having to fit two cars like this in the video, it just shows courtesy and kindness and loving everybody around you because you're simply all the same, and that was very important to me. These are only a couple of the most amazing people that I met on this trip that I can now call friends and stay in contact with. Here is Genovese High School, where I had my placement and where I met the most amazing kids and teens. I was able to build bonds with them and talk to them and teach them the importance of education and their future while helping them with their English and improve their conversational skills. L'estate addosso, il ghiaccio a un braccio rotto, la voglia di tuffarsi, guardando entrare in acqua tutti gli altri. At Isola di Capri, I saw the most blue water that just made me realize that there's so much more that I haven't seen in the world, and all I want to do is learn more about it and travel and meet new people and new cultures and learn to face my fears even more than I already have while having to travel alone and meet completely new people that I would have never met otherwise. Settembre ci porti in una strana felicità, pensando ai cieli infuocati, ai brevi amori. Throughout the years, Italians have built strong faith over small things like this arch of love and a red horn that give them luck, that keep them grounded. I made unforgettable memories like having dinner with the girls, having the original margarita pizza, meeting all of these waiters that are all so fun and friendly. This blue grotto cave is by far one of the most amazing memories I made here. I was able to go in and experience this with these new friends and see this cave that just lights up with the natural sunlight that comes in from the outside. While being in here, the men that were conducting these small boats were singing original Italian songs. That was just a beautiful sound. e che settembre ci porti una strana felicità. Pensando ai cieli infuocati, ai brevi amori infiniti, respira questa libertà.
Being able to lay here in these beautiful beaches made me so sad, thinking that the kids I was working with couldn't go 1 to 2 hours away from a 20-year-old to experience this because their parents were either working or didn't have the money to do so. I am so happy I was able to capture this because it was on our way home and it's something I will never forget. I also thought it was very different and something I'm not used to see the way that Italians park. They don't really care of whether they're on a double lane or not, and it just feels very at home. Quick side note, the stairs going up to our apartment was not the most fun and it was very tiring. This was jet lag and how late we couldn't go to sleep and we would just find anything to laugh about, like going down the stairs backwards. Had an Australian friend who was not scared of very big insects and decided to pick one of them up in the home and just scare us around with it. We thought it was hilarious. We were laughing. It was gross. This was a very small window in the house that I always loved looking out from, and the hallway that just brings so many memories. This was a room in which we had Wi-Fi and we hung out in. We played games like Uno and we just stayed up all night having fun, and our kitchen in which we had to be very careful and keep very clean, but it was so much fun. This has been the most unforgettable trip and experience I could ever ask for, in which I learned to face so many fears of mine and learn so much about myself and about others, and learning to motivate others and learning about struggles and my own, not just everyone else's, and learning a new culture. And it just has been so humbling that I would do it all over again. To go. Everybody got the reason, everybody got the way. We're just catching and releasing what builds up throughout the day. It gets into your body and it flows right through your blood. I want to say thank you so much to IVHQ for giving me the experience of a lifetime, and thank you for watching. Da-dum-dum-dum. Da-dum-dum-dum.